Yes, I hear you, and I've been hearing you for the last 15 minutes. I'm on top of it. How many times do you need to... Yes, I'm on top of it. I'm meeting with... I've got a few other guys to meet this week, and then... I know that there's a time restraint. I understand that.
Thanks for taking the time to meet me.
Yes. Well, I know what he wants. I understand what he wants. He's told me what he wants. You don't have to tell me what he wants as well, okay?
Okay.
Just, can you hold on for a second?
Okay, but
thank
I don't
you.
Have a long
no,
time.
Just be quiet. I take any of the other top quarterbacks available, and I get praise, and I get to keep my job. Hmm? I pick you, a player that barely even picked up a ball in college, and then I'm nuts. And the seat that I've got to sit on gets red hot. So why don't you tell me why you should even be on my radar?
I just won a national championship. And that's not the last trophy I plan to have on my mantle. You pick me? Better clear your shelf for some hardware.
Hey, I'm gonna have to call you back.
Call me back, but...
Yes, I'll have to call you back.
Hey, I love you.
I love you too, Dad.
Bye.
Are you for real? You know, you and I have a mutual friend, Mr. Jack Ford. He and I served on the same staff in St. Louis. What do you think he would have to say about your ability to lead a locker room?
Navigating a locker room can be tricky. I do my best. I try to find a balance between being the locker room guy and then the guy that the coaches can rely on to get the team bought in. But it's hard.
You know, Jack had some concerns about your leadership. But I'm not seeing that. Little inside scoop. The owner wants someone with the measurables. So you go out there and you impress. You'll be on our radar.
I can do that.
Don't let me down.
Thank you.
Hand over your phone. I want to check your internet history.
You want me to give you my phone? Is it that just like normal procedure?
You bet it is. You just give anyone your phone? If someone asks for your playbook, would you give them that too?
No. What? What?
You have something to hide? Look, son, this interview's about transparency.
I think I'm being quite transparent.
Not transparent enough.
You're on a mountain in Alaska on a bus going 100 miles an hour. Where are you sitting on the bus?
Bus in Alaska. I go front of the bus.
Not middle.
Nope.
Have you looked at the engine before you even got into the bus? Did you check the tire pressure?
I hired a professional mechanic to inspect every part of the bus, as he is more qualified than me, and I am aware of my strengths and weaknesses.
Are you being cute with me, son?
No.
You're not. Now give me a serious answer. Would you be in the front of the bus, the middle of the bus, or the back of the bus, or the passenger side of the bus?
I already answered the front of the bus.
Why?
Because if I can see where we're going, I can make sure... Well, okay, is that the wrong answer?
Funny how many eyes are on us right now, huh? Breaking us down, picking us apart. Every mistake amplified. But we got it though, right? At least I know I do.
Hey, I'm looking for your agent.
I don't have an agent.
Didn't have an agent. Les Moore, congratulations.
For what?
For getting an agent. Me. Boom.
I don't think. Have I met you before?
You're about to know me.
Quarterbacks, group four.
Looks like you're up to throw, kid. Go get him. Or should I say, go get him, client?
No, I'm good, man. Yeah.
Yeah. That's good. Got a lot of people already. Full roster. Too full.
Thanks, man. York fans were very vocal about you this week on social media. How would you feel about playing for the Giant?
Well, they're right. That's a team that needs a leader. And they know I could be the guy for them.
Very true.
What do you feel is your biggest strength as an NFL quarterback?
Well, I pride myself in my ability to get the job done. I'm able to focus and perform under pressure. I think you guys saw that in a college playoff.
You definitely did.
What do you say to the critics that think you weren't ready to play in the NFL?
Have any of these critics ever played football? Honestly, I don't care what they say. It's all white noise to me. All that really matters is what those NFL teams think, guys.
Let's say this all doesn't work out for you. What's your plan B?
No plan B for me.
It's a great answer.
It's very smart. Thank you.
Bavarian chocolate cake. Nice twist. That's my client. Let it go to voicemail. Build some anticipation. But if you answer it, you'll show that the teams can count on you. Answer it.
Hello?
Congratulations. You're one of the select few players invited to this year's NFL draft in Nashville. Please have your agent contact our office, and we'll see you in the Music City in April. Yes, sir. What can I help
you with? Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yes! Oh, sorry. Wait. What are you gonna wear?
I never even thought about that.
Come on, Les. Think. What is he gonna wear? A suit.
I don't have a suit.
We can purchase one.
Okay. Give him the goods. Put this guy out, huh? It's a winner right there. Yeah. Come on, give him a turn. Give him a spin.
Over here.
That's it. Yeah, drink it all in.
It's okay, you don't have to do that. It's okay.
I don't think I have to do that.
Okay, right.
Give me the over-shoulder look.
There he is.
Look right here. Looking good, man. Look my way. Hey, my way.
What's going on?
Oh, just you, please.
Yep, yeah, no. Take it all in. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank
you. Thank you. Nice.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey, this guy. How
are you? Welcome to the 2019 National Football League Draft live on NFL Network. An amazing spectacle right here in Nashville, Tennessee, that has been filled with intrigue and drama. And it is all about to suddenly subside with answers to longstanding questions involving the Heisman Trophy winner, Kyler Murray. DJ, you're first. What are you expecting to see tonight?
Well, I'm just waiting for this first pick, not knowing what's going to happen with the first pick and Kyler Murray specifically. That, to me, is the biggest story in this entire draft.
And for me, over the last few years, it's been about movement to get quarterbacks. You know, I'm looking to see, is there going to be some movement? Are people going to start jumping up?
From Hollywood Brown and Cody Ford.
Six picks left in the first round. Can't afford my condo representing a second rounder. Sorry. I need more clients. Signaling here. Stinks. Hey, anybody know how much a 26th pick makes? No? If that's the bank calling about my condo loan, tell them I'm not here. Just...
Hello?
Hey, this is Brian Flores, head coach of the Miami Dolphins. We've had our eye on you for a while. We're excited. We're going to make you the newest member of the Miami Dolphins. You ready to go on that?
Coach, I'm ready to make 25 other teams regret their decision.
Good. That's what I like to hear. Welcome to the Miami Dolphins.
Thank you.
Come on!
He's covered up here.
He hesitates a little bit. Put the timing of that throw on the money. Doesn't have to throw it 40 yards down the field.
Yeah.
Put it on the money, and you get a big play. Here we go. Here's the commissioner with a pick.
Oh, ho, ho. Players only.
In the 2019 NFL draft,
The Miami Dolphins select.
Let's start at the top with the Dolphins. Draft winners or draft losers?
Losers.
How could you call them losers?
They filled the need at quarterback. That's great. They filled the need. They got a quarterback. Yay! And they spent a first-round pick on a six-round talent. That's a winner?
Six-round talent? Did you watch this dude play?
Yeah.
Did you see him at the
Thank
combine?
You.
Are you
Thank
serious? You. He's been jumping up the draft boards for months.
Yeah, I watched him sit on the sideline in college. He couldn't even start for his college team. He's going to save an NFL franchise. Sure
yes,
he is.
And I'll tell you why. This isn't college. For the first time in his life, he actually has a coaching staff who is putting their faith in him. A coaching staff that actually believes in him.
So where are we headed?
Oh, isn't it on the app?
That you?
Yeah.
You know, I wasn't gonna say anything because I'm a professional. But for what it's worth, I think you are the guy that's gonna turn things around here for our quarterback situation. You know, I played a little JUCO ball myself.
That's cool, man. That's cool.
Had the coach in here last week, and I was not impressed at all. I do a little JV coaching in my spare time, so I have a really good feel about the game. Should have told him one of my plays. He could have used it this Sunday.
You know, I actually haven't met him yet.
Coach Flores? He called defensive plays up in New England last year. But I'm a little worried about our offense. No offense. We lost Tannehill, Danny Amendola, the old workhorse, Frank Gore. They're all gone. You know that our best receiver is our running back. I get why they drafted you even after taking Rosen, because I think you could be the next Marino. And if the coaches don't see that, tell them to call me. I'll tell them.
Thanks. I'll pass it along. Not really sure how much they'll listen to me, though. I'm just a rookie.
Had Chris Pratt in here last week. Good-looking guy. I think if he fights a Raptor, the Raptor's gonna win. That's just me. That's just me. I don't care how many names he calls me. In fact, I actually did some... I do some archaeology on the side. And I found a T-Rex bone in Missouri once. I think it was a T-Rex bone. I was like, look at... Whoa!
Sorry about that.
Cool, cool, cool. Actually, I think you can just drop me off right up here, man.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Just right up front. Thank you.
The start of something beautiful, kid. And in this city, if you need anything, if you need alpacas, if you need emus, any type of livestock, home loan, or warranty, you call me.
You're the guy.
If you... I think we'll call.
This game, it's about legacy, kid. Achievement. Exceeding expectations. Your college accolades, they're in the past. Your draft status, just a number. But your legacy, you start building that today. It's about the way you interact with teammates, coaches, opponents. It's about fearlessness, week in, week out. Overcoming the onslaught of the league's top defenders. Demonstrating leadership in everything you do. From how you play to what you wear. It's about laying a strong foundation in your rookie season. Becoming the quarterback I always knew you were. But first, right now, it's about winning the starting job. Good luck out there, kid.